I'm absolutely delighted that Jim Mulva has been able to join me. So thank you so much, Chief Executive and Chairman of ConocoPhillips. Now, we listen to you and to many of the ministers to talk about the need for stronger cooperation in this industry, now more than ever. This is where you have to be going forward. You have to be going forward together, really.
Yes, we do. And we need to work together because, in the end, we have the same objective, and that is to supply energy to the world. And we have to do this in a way that is acceptable from a cost point of view, take the volatility out of energy prices, and then we know that we have to do it in a way that meets the expectations of the consuming public in the world with respect to environmental performance and expectations.
Now, from the minister side and the producer side, low oil prices will hamper investment and it will hamper production. This is not good. But from an international oil company too, nobody really wants to see sustained low prices. It's not good for the industry.
Well, a few things. First, the lower energy prices and oil prices at this point in time is a very tangible and very significant stimulus to the worldwide economy, because it puts, with lower energy prices, it does give, puts cash right into the hands of the consuming public around the world. The other thing is we invest for the long term. So even though we may see the short term in prices, we know with some recovery in the economy that the price levels will more than likely go up somewhat in a moderate way. But it's also an opportunity for us to get our cost structure down in terms of the new projects that we invest in and capital spending and the operating costs. So it's an environment that we have to aggressively work on our cost structure.
Also, quickly looking at the relationship between the IOCs and the NOCs, another thing that really has to strengthen going forward.
Well, that's true, and I think we do have good cooperation between the IOCs and the NOCs. And we're always looking for new paradigms, new models by which we can participate and cooperate with each other. And that takes a bit of ingenuity. It also takes finding the right opportunity by which we can complement IOC and NOCs working together. And it just means a different paradigm, looking at a new and different way of approaching. But we still have the same fundamental objective, and that is to develop energy in a cost-effective way.
Finally now, just quick look ahead, looking to the future. What do you think are the main challenges that are out there for producers, for consumers, for companies like yourself in the next, for the rest of the year, really?
Well, the real challenge, obviously, for us is the easy to find oil and gas has already been essentially found. And for an international oil company like ourselves, access is an issue. So we are looking at more challenging environments that are technically more complex. So the cost of more unconventional, more difficult to find oil and gas is more costly. And so we have to be working in a way that how can we, with new technology, each decade that passes, develop our technology so as to tap these more difficult to find resources and do it in a cost-effective way. And the other challenge for everyone is to develop and attract human resources to our business and to our industry. And that's the technology that's associated with oil and gas. It may be a mature industry, but the technology is phenomenal. And we need to continue to develop technology.